Hi friends, very good morning. I just got back from my morning routine of exercise, and as you can see in this video that weather is a little cloudy, or rather foggy. The fog is at a higher level and I'm sure it will clear up after some time. It will be quite bright and sunny. It's windy, it's adding to the chill factor, but nevertheless, if you want to do a workout, it's always a good weather. In fact, this is the best weather. But I have come in front of you not because I want to tell you about the weather at NCR, but I was very perturbed yesterday when I heard about the crash of Mirage 2000 at HAL Bangalore. HAL of late has been in the talks, the political narrative, for a very long time. If you recall, Rahul Gandhi had gone there and told the guys and the employees over there that Narendra Modi's government has marred your huck, you know, by giving a Rafale offset thing to Ambani. So HAL has been under spotlight. But what has happened yesterday actually brings the fact out. It's a proof by itself that why HAL was not selected by the SAW. Now what happened yesterday? These are Mirage 2000 fighter aircrafts that had come for upgrading. And these two young pilots were there to test fly these this aircraft and accept it back from the HAL. So what happened was that when this aircraft got onto the runway and picked up speed, the controls got jammed. Controls got jammed, they aborted, they rejected takeoff, and every procedure what was supposed to be done, they did it. And how I know? Because I was talking to an Air Force guy in the morning, and then he told me. So while I was doing my workout, this thing was brewing in my mind that I must speak to the people, at least put across a perspective. So when these guys aborted the aircraft was at a very tremendous speed. And mind you, the stick had got jammed. It had got jammed. The aircraft refused to take off. The controls were totally jammed. So after aborting takeoff, rejecting takeoff, the aircraft crashed into the arrest barrier, broke the arrest barrier, and took to flames. The pilot sitting behind in this tandem flight, he ejected. He ejected, but the momentum was such that immediately after ejecting, his chute deployed, but he landed on the wreck itself, which was burning. So the pilot in front died instantly, and this gentleman also died because of somebody's negligence. Now the question is, will the engineers of HAL be summoned? Will they be charged of culpable homicide, negligence? That is the point. Will any citizen of India press nota for not getting these organizations accountable? That is the question. I don't think so it will happen that way, because HAL and such organizations are big black hole where government gives in a lot of money and it is siphoned back into the personal coffers of various officials in the MOD and the politicians. So nobody would like to kill the golden goose. But one feels very sad that such important, innocent lives of an Indian has been lost, or Indians have been lost. They have left behind their families, their parents, their wives and children for no fault of theirs. So when the SAW says that we cannot give contract to HAL, is because of this reason, because HAL guys are not professional. And if you recall, just day before, Air Chief had said that a very famous quote that has become very famous now, that while we give a lot of concessions to the HAL, will the enemy give us that concession? So that is the point, and I leave you with this thought. Mull over it and spread this video, spread the knowledge. Thank you. Thanks for watching.